Hi friends, welcome to another math lesson with Miss Carter. So we're gonna start out how we normally do. I have some counting bears in front of me that I just want you to count. So take a few minutes and count these bears for me. Ready, go. Awesome, okay. So tell Miss Carter, how many bears did you count? I heard 7, I heard 6. Let's see, ready? We're gonna count them together. So, ready? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So how many counting bears do we have? 8, good job. We have 8 counting bears, okay? And I want you to tell me, are they in a linear configuration, an array configuration, or are they scattered? Linear, good job. How do you know that they're linear? Thomas Carter, how do you know? Because they're in a line, perfect, okay? So Ms. Carter's going to move our counting bears for you. And we are going to do a quick tell me the number. I feel like we haven't done that in a while. Do you think we've done that? So, ready? Let's go. Ready? What number? 10. Good job. Thomas Carter. What number? 0. Good job. Thomas Carter. What number? 6. Good job. And Thomas Carter, what number? 3. Good job. Thomas Carter, what number? 5. Good job. And lastly, what number? 8. Good job, friends. Awesome telling me the number. So for today's math lesson, we're going to go over big, and we're gonna go over small, okay? We're gonna go over the difference between big, do it with me, and small. One more time, we're gonna go over the difference between big and small, okay? So, Ms. Carter has some stuff here, okay? So, you know, because we're all at home, Ms. Carter has all these books, okay? She has all these books that she's been reading while we've been at home. Okay, and Miss Carter is trying to know, can my books fit in a big book bag like this? Or should they go in something smaller like this? Where should my books go? Because if we're doing big and small and I have all these books, where should they go? In my big book bag, right? So let's see. Miss Carter's gonna try and see if she can fit all her big books in her book bag. Look, do you think Miss Carter's gonna be able to fit all these books in her book bag? Yes! Okay, good job. So when we're talking about big, okay, we put things in here, like my books, because they literally, and Miss Carter will show you, they literally fit perfectly, okay? All my books fit in my backpack perfectly, okay? And I have so many books, so I need them in something bigger, like this backpack, okay? Because if Miss Carter tried to fit all her books, if I tried to fit all my books in this bag, is it gonna fit? Let's see. Okay, so where should my books go again? In my big backpack or my small little purse? In my big backpack, right? Because we need everything to fit perfectly, okay? Good job. Now we're gonna talk about, now that we talked about something big, we're gonna talk about something small, okay? So when we look at this bag, is it big like my backpack or is it small? It's small. Good job. So, Miss Carter has some stuff in here. She's just gonna take out really quickly so that we can see. Because remember, when we're telling the difference between big and small, we need to fit perfectly. That's how we know, okay? So, these are all of Miss Carter's little chapsticks, okay? So, do you think Miss Carter should put all of her chapsticks in this big bag? Or should I put them in the small bag? Okay, I'll put them in the big bag. Let's see. Oh, okay, let's see. They fit perfectly. Do they fit perfectly? I don't know. It seems kind of hard. Because when this card goes, oh, let's see if I can find a chapstick. Oh man, this is so hard. It feels nice, but it doesn't fit perfectly. Because Miss Carter has to do all this work just to look in here just to find one chapstick. Okay? So I think we can rule out that this may not fit in this bag. Okay? But let's see. If Miss Carter goes to something smaller, like this bag, let's see. All my chapsticks fit perfectly in this small bag, okay? And Miss Carter can easily look through, okay, and figure out which chapstick she wants to put on today, okay? Which chapstick she's gonna put on today. Like, oh, I could just pull it out easily, or I can pull this one out easily, okay? So remember, the difference between big and small is how things fit perfectly, okay? Because if I put, again, if I put all my chapsticks in my big bag, is that where it should go? Why? Because it doesn't fit perfectly, right? Miss Carter would struggle, okay? But if I put them on here, they fit perfectly inside my little compartment, okay? Whereas if Miss Carter has all these books like this, where should they go? Should they go in my big backpack or my small little pocketbook? In my big backpack, right. Why should they go in my big backpack? Tell me, why should they go in there? Because they fit perfectly. Good job, friend. That was a very fun math lesson. What I want you to do at home is find things that are big and small around your house. Maybe find a backpack, or maybe ask for like maybe your parents' little purse or wallet, and see if you can make sure that you can tell the difference between big and small, just like we did with Miss Carter, okay? And remember, you know that it's big or if it's small when the items fit perfectly, okay? Because they can fit perfectly like Miss Carter's, and you can easily pick them out, okay? Or like in our books, okay? Books fit perfectly inside my bag, and I can easily pick out a book and say, oh, I wanna read this one, okay? Don't forget to send us pictures and videos. Bye, guys.